Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 20, practice test 4, section 3, no calculator, found in the new SAT study guide, the official new SAT study guide released by College Board. Okay, so the mesosphere is the layer of Earth's atmosphere between 50 kilometers and 85 kilometers above Earth's surface. At a distance of 50 kilometers from Earth's surface, the temperature in the mesosphere is -5 degrees Celsius, and at a distance of 80 kilometers from Earth's surface, the temperature in the mesosphere is -80 degrees Celsius. For every additional 10 kilometers from Earth's surface, the temperature in the mesosphere decreases by k degrees Celsius, where k is a constant. What is the value of k? Okay, so the first thing I would do, I noticed that there are points involved, points and slope, right? And how do I know that? Well, because points I determined from this, it says at a distance of 50 kilometers from our surface, the temperature in the mesosphere is -5 degrees Celsius. So that means there's a function of some sort, right? There's a function of one variable in terms of the other. Well, what is the dependent variable? Well, the dependent variable here is the temperature, right? Because the temperature depends on the distance away from the Earth's surface, right? In depth, right? So, this distance from the Earth's surface up in the air, right? So, not below the ground. Okay, so at a distance of 50 kilometers from the Earth's surface, so the temperature is dependent on the distance, right? So the distance is your x and the temperature is the y, right? And this is one point. And the second point I would use would be the distance. It says a distance of 80 kilometers from your surface, the temperature in the mesosphere is -80 degrees. So that means that the temperature of here again is dependent on the distance, and this is the second point. So that means 80 would be the x and -80 degrees Celsius, right? -80 would be the y. Right, so I have two points so far, 50 and -5, right, because the temperature -5 depends on the distance, 50 kilometers from the Earth's surface, right? We're talking about above Earth's surface, right, up in the air. And then the second point will be 80 comma -80, and again the -80 degrees Celsius temperature is dependent on the distance away from the Earth's surface, a distance above the Earth's surface, which is 80 kilometers, right? So we have two points thus far, right? And that's enough. And let's see how that works. And now, how do we know there's slope involved? Well, it says for every 10 kilometers, additional kilometers from Earth's surface, the temperature in the mesosphere decreases by k degrees Celsius, right? So it says, so for every change of 10, in the x coordinate, right, there is a change, negative change of k degrees, right? So that means, and remember, slope is found by the change in y divided by the change in x, right? And the y is the temperature and the x is the distance above the Earth's surface, right? So that means that the minus k divided by 10 is the slope, right? Minus k represents the negative change in temperature in degrees Celsius per every 10 kilometers above added above the Earth's surface, right? So the higher you go, for every 10 kilometers that you go up, right, away from the Earth's surface, above the Earth's surface, you will have decreased the temperature by 10 by k degrees Celsius, right? And which is why this determines the slope, minus k. And why is this not k and why is this minus k? Because it says decreases, right? So we have to show the negative sign and by k degrees Celsius. So k must be positive in itself, but the degrees must be accompanied by a negative sign, right? So it's going to be minus k over 10. Now, why do we set it equal? We set it equal because we can use this, these two points, that will show the same slope numerically, right? Because we know how to calculate the slope from these two points. The slope is going to be constant, right? Based on what's written here, the slope is constant, doesn't change. So we can use these two points to calculate the same slope and set it equal to the slope, to the same slope that we use the k for, right? So it's going to be -80 minus negative 5, remember, because change in y, divided by change in x, which is 80 minus 50, right? And then we simplify, we will have negative k divided by 10 is equal to minus 75, because two negatives give you a positive, net positive, so it's minus 80 plus 5, which is minus 75, divided by 80 minus 50, which is 30. So now you're ready to cross multiply, and you're going to have negative 30k, right? The product of the means is equal to the product of the extremes, right? So minus 30k is equal to, what is minus 75 times 10? It's negative 750, right? And now you set k is equal to, because you divide both sides by negative 30, and you're going to have negative 750 divided by the negative 30, and the zeros are out, right? Because that's the common number in the numerator and the denominator, right? The multiplier 10, right? So, and also the negatives cancel out, give you a positive, so that's going to be 75 divided by 3. And that should be really easy for you to know without the calculator, that 25 is equal to 75 divided by 3, right? So 25 is the correct answer. That's the value of k. So that means for every 10 additional kilometers from the Earth's surface, the temperature in the mesosphere decreases by 25 degrees Celsius.